Hi friends, I am Suresh Kumar. Today I am going to teach you one of the most important topic, geometry, shape, structure, bond angle of molecules. These topics comes under chemical bonding, VSEPR theory. Okay, in chemical bonding, three important theories are there. What are they? Valence bond theory, molecular orbital theory, VSEPR theory, or valence shell electron pair repulsion theory. Valence bond theory and molecular orbital theory explains the orbital contribution in bonding. This is the basic for quantum mechanics. VSEPR theory or valence shell electron pair repulsion theory is used to find hybridization, geometry, shape, structure and bond angle of molecules. Hybridization, geometry, shape, structure and bond angle of molecules. So in previous video I have explained the hybridization tricks. So what is the formula for hybridization? Hybridization is equal to total number of bond pair or sigma bonds plus total number of lone pairs or non-bonding electrons. Okay, so I will repeat. Hybridization is equal to total number of bond pairs or sigma bonds plus total number of lone pairs or non-bonding electrons. Okay, non-bonding electrons. For predicting the geometry, shape, structure, VSEPR theory gives this bond pair repulsion and bond pair lone pair, lone pair lone pair repulsion. So bond pair repulsion is lower than bond pair is lower than bond pair lone pair repulsion is lower than lone pair repulsion. Lone pair repulsion is higher. So these lone pair this part. This lone pair decides the shape of the structure given molecule. Lone pair decides the shape of the molecules. Why this topic is important? These are the most important topics. These are the most important topics in chemistry. You can see these topics. If you know these, if you understand the basic concept from chemical bonding, you can understand and answer questions from these topics. If you understand the concept, you can remember with some tricks. Okay. In this video series, I am going to make you understand these concepts. If you're new to this channel, please subscribe my future videos, my channel for future videos. Don't miss it. Okay. Let us move to the today topic. Friends, please note this table in your trick notebook like this. If you write my tricks in your trick notebook, you can use it with whenever required. You can revise these topics very fast for any examination. Okay, please watch the video up to the end. I hope you will learn some new concept from this topic. Please write like this. Okay, let us move to the topic. So if you know the hybridization, you can predict the geometry. If you know the bond pair and lone pair electrons in a molecule, you can predict the shape. If you know the shape, you can predict the structure. If you know the structure, you can predict the bond angle of the molecule, bond angle of the given molecule. If you know the hybridization, so if you're new to this channel, this video, please watch my previous video, hybridization. So you can understand how you can calculate the hybridization. If you know the hybridization, we can predict the geometry. If you know the hybridization, we can predict the shape. If you know this shape, you can predict the structure. If you know the structure, we can predict the bond angle. Okay, so if you know the hybridization, you can tell, based on hybridization, you can predict the geometry. Okay, so based on the lone pairs, you can predict the shape. So please note this table. Okay, if you know the geometry and the shape, you can predict the structure. So this is the trick here. How can we remember the structure, geometry and shape? In this video you will learn. Okay, so I will teach you how to remember the geometry, shape. Okay, geometry and shape are differ. Examiners ask you to confuse. Okay, so you just remember geometry and shape are different. This geometry is common, if you hybridization is common to all geometry, but shape is differ. So shape differ based on the lone pairs in the molecule. Okay, so based on the lone pairs, the shape is differ. Okay, so based on the 3D structure, we can remember the shape of the molecules and the geometry of the molecules. Okay, so first sp hybridization, we know how to predict, calculate the hybridization. So sp, so this is the type of the molecule ax2. So ax2, I use this. So here you can see these two balls, just remember these two balls here. So these three balls are lie on the same plane, isn't it? In linear, the three balls are lie in the same plane. So A X X. So these bonds are bond pair electrons. So bond pair repulsion that accommodate more space. Okay. So these occupy more than 50% in the approximately 50% areas of the molecule. Okay. So linear X A X. So these atoms are lie on the plane, same plane. So they lie on the same plane. Okay. Sp2 hybridization, the type of molecule is AX3. AX3. Here the molecules are lie on the same plane like this. Okay. Like this. Central atom, these are neighboring atoms. All four atoms are lie on the plane. Okay, so just remember like this. The imagination is better than knowledge. So just imagine like this. So these are lie on the plane AXXX. So the structure of the geometry of the molecule is, this is linear, this is trigonal planar, because these all four atoms are lie on the plane. So trigonal planar. So trigonal planar is the geometry. Okay, if one lone pair electron is replaced in this geometry, what about the shape? So the shape of this molecule is angular or V shape or bent. Angular or V shape or bent. Okay, so you replace one atom or neighboring atom with one lone pair electron, that means non bonding electrons. So there were no bonding. In sp3 hybridization, so three atoms are lie on the plane like this. Central atom, neighboring atoms, these three are lie on the plane. One atom above the plane, one atom below the plane. So only we give this representation. This widget means the atom is above the plane, this dotted line means that is below the plane. Okay, so just remember that in sp3 hybridization, three atoms lie on the plane. Okay, other two atoms are one above the plane, one below the plane. Okay, what is the geometry? Geometry is tetrahedral. Geometry is tetrahedral. If one electron is replaced, what about the shape? The shape is varying. If one electron is replaced, if the one electron is replaced, that we call pyramidal. Okay, so pyramidal shape. This is pyramidal shape. This is tetrahedral geometry. Here the geometry of this molecule, this type, is also tetrahedral, but the shape is varying. The shape is pyramidal. So if you replace any two atom, either this part or this part, so two lone pairs are occupied here. This mean that means no bonding. Only two neighboring groups, neighboring atoms are participate. That molecule be called, this shape of the molecule is V shape. So you can see like V shape. So these three atoms are lie on the plane. So we call that as a V shape or angular or bent. V shape. V shape, angular V shape or bent. Okay, so two lone pairs are present. Just remember like that. Okay, for sp3d hybridization, the type of molecule is AX5. AX5. Okay, how can we represent? So here, the three atoms are lie on the same plane with the central atom. So here, central atom, neighboring atoms are lie on the plane 1, 2, 3, 4. So this we call plane. Okay, one atom above the plane, that coordinate with attached with the central atom, another one molecule attached with the bottom. So above the plane, below the plane. So I'll represent like this. So the here the atoms are above the so same plane. Okay, so these three four atoms lie on the plane. So this looks like trigonal, so we call that as a trigonal planar, because these two three these four atoms are lie on the plane. So trigonal planar, so that is the geometry, trigonal planar sp3d hybridization. The geometry is trigonal planar, by sorry, trigonal bipyramidal, sorry, trigonal bipyramidal. Why we call that as the trigonal bipyramidal? So the shape is like this. This coordination looks like the pyramid shapes. So we call that as a one above the plane, one below the plane. So we looks like pyramid. Pyramid. So we call that as a bipyramid. Trigonal bipyramid. Trigonal bipyramid for sp3d hybridization. That is a geometry. If you replace, if only lone pair electron, that means no bonding. So this occupy the equatorial position. Okay, this position we call equatorial position. Equatorial position, that is the lie on the plane. Okay, if the molecules are occupied in the axial, so above the plane and below the plane, we call that as a axial position. These positions we call equatorial, equatorial, equatorial. This position we call axial, axial. Okay, axial, axial. So if we replace with one lone pair electrons, what about the shape? So shape is varying. Okay, that participate like four neighboring atom, like our tetrahedral. So we call that as a distorted tetrahedral, distorted tetrahedral shape, distorted tetrahedral shape. Another name is zisa. So distorted tetrahedral or zisa, one electron is, one lone pair is occupied. If two lone pairs are occupied, that also occupied in the equatorial position. This position we call equatorial position. Okay, this position we call equatorial position. Okay, so this looks like T shape. This looks like T shape. So central atom and one neighboring atom is lie in the same plane. One neighboring atom is above the plane, another atom is below the plane. Okay, so the shape is T shape, trigonal planar. One lone pair is zisa or distorted tetrahedral. Two lone pairs means T shape. Okay, so if three lone pairs are occupied in the equatorial position, what about the shape? So the one, the central atom is lie in the plane, lie in the plane. One atom above the plane, one atom below the plane. So that looks like linear. Okay, that looks like linear, like this. So atoms lie like this, but one above the plane, one below the plane. Okay, so neighboring at the parent atom, so central atom is present in the plane, but one atom above the plane, one atom is below the plane. Okay, so that we call linear shape. Okay, linear shape. In sp3d hybridization, the type of molecule is ax6. ax6, the shape is like this. Here the central atom is surrounded by four neighboring atoms, four neighboring atoms like this. So consider the central atom and neighboring atoms like this. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, this x's are this atoms. Okay, this middle is this. So 5 atoms lie on the plane, 1 atom above the plane, 1 atom above the plane, 1 atom below the plane. So the geometry of the hybridization sp3d2 hybridization is octahedral. Geometry of sp3d2 hybridization is octahedral. Okay, if you replace with the one lone pair electrons, so that means the electrons replaced from the above the molecule, this or below, this atom or this atom. Okay, above the plane or below the plane atom. So this representation indicate above the plane, this representation indicate below the plane. In either of this you can replace. Okay, what about the geometry? Geometry is octahedral. What about the shape? Shape is varying because lone pair is occupied here. The shape is square pyramidal. Square pyramidal. Why we call that as a square pyramidal? So this looks like square. Okay, central atom A, X, X, square planar, square type, and one atom is present here. So this looks like this pyramid like. Okay, so only square pyramidal, square pyramidal. Okay, so this four atoms lie in the same plane, four and central atom. So it's four neighboring atom and central atom lie in the same plane. One is above the, one neighboring atom is above the plane, one atom is below the plane. So we call it as a octahedral. Now we replace one lone pair, so we call it as a square pyramidal. Okay, square pyramidal. Here we replace two lone pair electrons. So here we replace this lone pair also. So we call it as a square planar. Square planar. This we call square. All atoms are lie on the plane, so we call that is a square planar. Square planar. This is square pyramidal. This is square planar. Square pyramidal, square planar. Okay, I hope you understood. Next, sp3d2 hybridization. AX7 is a hybridization molecule. Here we can use the pentagonal like structure. Okay, so here this is a central atom. You just consider central atom. 5 neighboring atoms are occupying here. So central atom and 5 neighboring atoms lie on the plane. One atom above the neighboring atom above the plane, one is below the plane. One above the plane, one below the plane. Like this. Okay. So pentagonal bipyramidal. Pentagonal bipyramidal. The structure. So this shape is pentagonal. Pentagonal. So one is above the plane, one is below the plane. So that looks like pyramid shape. So pentagonal, this pentagonal, this one pyramid, another pyramid. So we call pyramid. So we call pentagonal. Two pyramids are there, so bipyramid. Pentagonal bipyramidal geometry. If you replace, so these 5 atoms are the same plane. If you replace one lone pair electron from the axial position here, the above the plane and below the plane and neighboring groups are called axial positions. Okay, these here, these are called equatorial position. These are axial position. Okay. These are axial, above the plane, axial. The plane, the atoms lie in the plane, we call that as the equatorial position. Okay, here. So atoms are occupied in the equatorial position. So this lone pair occupied in the axial position. Okay, so we replaced one pyramid here. So the shape of the molecule is, if we one lone pair is occupied, only one pyramid is there, so pentagonal pyramidal. Okay, only one pyramid shape is there, so we call it as a pentagonal pyramidal. pyramidal. Okay, so next, two lone pairs are occupied in the axial position. So two lone, one pyramid is replaced here, so we call it as a pentagonal pyramidal. Here two lone pairs are occupied in the axial position, two pyramids are removed, so we call it as a pentagonal planar. So five neighboring atoms and central atoms are present in the plane, so we call pentagonal planar. Pentagonal planar. Okay, so pentagonal, this is pentagonal bipyramidal, this pentagonal pyramidal, this is pentagonal planar. Okay, now you can remember this structure. Okay, one more thing, in trigonal bipyramidal, you can see the lone pairs are occupied in the equatorial position. The equatorial position, the lone pairs are occupied in octahedral and pentagonal bipyramidal. You can see the lone pairs occupied in axial position. This may ask in your exams. This concept is very important for higher level exams. Okay. In next video, I will explain with the examples. Okay, how we can predict the geometry using the examples. I hope you understood the concept. Thank you very much for your support. Please, if you like this video, please share with your friends. Please subscribe. Thank you.